Hey everyone, it's me, Arthur Kade, and tonight we're on the red carpet for the New York premiere of GOAT, where we're chatting with the brilliant cast, including Ben Schnetzer, Nick Jonas, James Franco, and more. So get ready for a great night behind the velvet rope. Hey everyone, it's me, Arthur Kade, James Franco. This movie looks really freaking intense, man. What is everybody going to get with GOAT?
They are going to get an intense experience. It is based on a nonfiction memoir about two brothers that join a fraternity. And basically the movie is a full-on journey into what it's like to be hazed and join a fraternity.
It's amazing because this topic is so relevant right now, especially with what's going on college campuses. Talk to me about when people see this, how is it going to reflect what we're living with today?
It's hard for me to tell. I teach at universities, but when I'm there as a teacher, I'm seeing everything from a completely different perspective. I go around to different schools and give talks and Q&As and stuff, and I've talked to people from different schools about fraternities, and especially like I was in Florida and down south, and fraternities are really big there. And I asked him like, oh, does the hazing still go on? Because knowing that this film was going to come out, and they said to me, no, we can't do that stuff anymore. And Andrew Neil is telling me that's a lot of bullshit. Like that
it's still
the
happening.
Statistics like surrounding hazing and all of that, and incidents surrounding hazing are like as high as ever. So I don't know.
You've got such a great thing happening, because obviously with all the success you've had in the pop arena, to then go to acting and have success is really remarkable. Talk to me about that, being able to make that transition, because not a lot of people have been able to.
You know, I think for me the key has been in just finding great projects that challenge me, push me in a new and exciting direction. You know, it was tough for a minute. It was tough for a minute to get people to believe that I could handle films like GOAT or TV shows like Kingdom, the one I'm on. But I think, you know, between pushing myself musically and really getting aggressive about, great material on the acting side, it's been an amazing couple of years. And, the projects that are kind of on the horizon are even more exciting, and I'm just anxious to keep going.
This topic right now is so relevant. We're still seeing on campuses the hazing issues. There's issues with campus rape. When you're able to tell a story that is effective today, what does that mean to you as an artist?
You know, I think that you have to do what you can to make a statement in some sense and speak about things that are relevant to everyone on some level, and hopefully it brings up some kind of change. You know, with this film, this is in no way an indictment of fraternity culture. There's probably a lot of great things about it. But it's should be used as a toolkit to say, all right, if you're a young person, you're headed to college, maybe watch this.
This is an intense movie. Talk to me about filming it.
It was, we kind of knew what we signed up for going into it. We knew, we saw the schedule. We had about 4 weeks to shoot it. So we knew it was going to be a sprint. And everybody was on the same page, everybody was on board, and we just went for it. You know, it's a relentless film, a pretty uncompromising film, but that's the movie we set out to make, and so I think we're all really proud of it.
I was never in a fraternity, so I never really saw hazing firsthand. Have you ever experienced anything like this in your life?
Nothing like that, no. I mean, I grew up with an older brother, I was a baby in my family, so, you know, you have like your fraternal, literal blood fraternal hazing, but nothing institutionalized like that, no.
To be fair, this is an extreme example of hazing. So it's not like every frat hazes this way to this extent on any level. I think this is the worst of the behavior, but it's a reality. And, you know, look, the thing on ESPN just came out a few days ago about hazing on athletic teams and you know, sodomy with broomsticks and all this stuff. It's not just fraternities, it's gangs, fraternities, social clubs, all, you know, hazing is a reality as far as human behavior is concerned. So
when you look at obviously adapting this from a book, How close as a director do you try to stay? Obviously, you have the script you're working off of, but how close do you try to stay to the source material?
You know, that's always like this balancing act, you know, like you obviously you have to sculpt the thing into what works for a three-act movie, but while maintaining just the right amount of reverence for what was there, you know, and usually like my rule is that the piece should have the spirit of what the original material had.
You wrote this book. Talk to me about, you lived this. How similar is to what we're seeing to what you lived?
Andrew and Nick and Ben and everybody else did a frighteningly good job. This will be my first time seeing it on the big screen, but I've seen it on a small screen and it really rocked my world. I mean, obviously, it was intense.
It was so accurate and beautiful.
Scary, yeah.
And Nick Jonas plays you in the movie, right?
Yeah.
How crazy is that? You got one of the biggest pop stars on the planet playing you in a movie.
It's pretty exciting.
Talk to me about that.
Yeah. Well, I told him he needed to live up to it.
You better bring his A game for that.
That guy's got game all day.
Yeah, it was great.